Hey everybody, I thought I would make a little review of my new heater. I saw a Val 6 heater, which is a much larger heater than this. It's also about a $2,600 radiant kerosene fueled heater. Saw it at an airport hangar and was blown away by how much heat it threw. Started looking around at infrared radiant kerosene heaters and within just a few days found this particular model. It's branded ProTemp Sunstream 70,000 BTU. There's an identical model, except it's yellow, called a Master Heater. Matter of fact, I think even the part number, the PT for ProTemp, and on the Master, I think it starts with MS. They're both made in China for Pinnacle International here, which is in Yardley, Pennsylvania. I call them, before I bought the unit, I called them. They do answer their phones. They do have a parts department. Parts are available, which if you've run a torpedo heater for a long period of time, I'm sure you've fed it some parts. As nice as this one looks, it's 10 years old, and it's needed a couple parts along the way. Of course, Reddy's out of business, but there's some great third-party support out there on the web. But they're noisy. They use more fuel than these radiants. This radiant actually, I think, has less fuel consumption, and it's 15,000 BTU more than my old trusty dusty Reddy heater there. So the only assembly on this was the handle and this little chin guard. It kind of looks like an afterthought. I don't even remember seeing that pictured on the website listings. I got this from Northern Tool, delivered for about $245. It says it's enough to heat 1,700 square feet. This is a 24 by 28 garage, which turns out to be like 580 square feet, so there's plenty of heat here. And it's not like I really had trouble heating my garage with this torpedo, and I've got a, I just moved, I'm not 100% settled yet, but we also got a 12,000 BTU non-electric cylindrical radiant. But I kind of like to save that for emergency use, since the wick does consume itself. But I really didn't have a problem. I could take this garage up about 30 degrees in 20 minutes. I took it the other night from, it was right at 30, took it up to 60 in about 20, 25 minutes. Killed the torpedo and had the radiant over here in my workspace and was fine. We've had crazy weather here recently. It was warm and 60 mile an hour winds today. So it's only 51 in the garage tonight. But I got a fresh 5 gallons of K1 and I just filled it up about 3/4 of the way. So enough jibber jabber, let's light it up. Let's see what it does. Hopefully it works, right? A piece of styrofoam blew out of it, that's exciting. Talked about some grinding when it first fired up to prime the pump. I just saw a little trickle of kerosene right out the front. No ignition, there's no heat coming out of the thing. That's not a very good start to my YouTube video. All right, that's it for now. See if we can get this thing to work. Okay, so I threw the switch on the heater and it made some grinding noises and didn't light. I looked at the back panel and said to re-attempt ignition, switch it off and switch it back to on, which I did. And it lit right up the second time. Definitely makes some different noises on startup than a torpedo heater. There's no doubt about that. You see the disc is getting more and more cherry red. I can feel the heat, even though I'm 45 degrees off the corner of it. The instructions there simply said, if it doesn't light, switch it off. The fan stayed running the whole time. The light was blinking when the fan was running, but it didn't light. When I switched it to off, the light went out. When I switched it on, the light started blinking again, and then when it lit, I'm assuming it went to solid. But I'll tell you one thing, compared to a roaring ass torpedo heater, She is nice and quiet, that is for sure. So the Val 6 is a pure radiant heater. Like I said, it's also almost $3,000. This is, it does have some air blowing out the front, although it's not a tremendous amount. You see, it just barely turns this paperwork when I hold it out there. It's not a raging fan like a torpedo heater, hence you have a lot less noise. Big advantage of the radiants is not only that they make a lot less noise, but they're supposed to actually warm up the objects in the room by infrared radiation rather than just blowing hot air around. So with it being 50 degrees tonight, I'm not going to find out anything about that, but it will be nice to see on a cold night get this place up to 60 degrees and open the garage door for 30 seconds and close it. Does all the heat rush out, or has it truly heated up the objects, which would then quickly reheat the air? I think that's what I'll be most curious about. I think I got 9 solid years out of my 55,000 BTU ready heater over there before I had any problems with it. First thing it needed was an igniter, but 9 years and probably a couple hundred gallons of kerosene. It's done a hell of a job over the years. Time will tell. This newer design, there's only a few out there in the market that are anywhere near this price range. Time will tell if this thing eats parts or if it's a reliable long-term heater. Alright, it's been a couple of days since my first video when I first unboxed this baby. It's definitely cooled down. Instead of in the 60s outside, it's been in the 20s and 30s for a couple of days now, so the garage has settled in at about 43 degrees. It's definitely cooler out here. This is really the first true test of this thing to see how quick it can change the temperature. When I first fired it, it didn't light. It blew a chunk of styrofoam out the front, made a couple of noises, I'm assuming when the fan blade smacked it. And then there was a little trickle of kerosene. Instructions on the back say if it fails to light, you switch it off and then switch it back on, and it'll reattempt ignition. It still runs even when you switch it off because it's got like a 5-minute cooling cycle. And it did light that second time the other night. But now that it's sat for a few days, I'm curious to see what it does on the first ignition attempt here tonight. So let's see what we get. There goes the motor. There's an ignition sound, or a spark plug sound, an electric sound. And add a little kerosene and a finely atomized cloud and you have ignition. Gotta love it. So we'll guess we'll call that first failure to light just a little out of the box teething problems. It looks like she's gonna light up on the first try now going forward. I have a feeling it shouldn't be an issue. I did notice before it took about, I don't know, 2 or 3 minutes for that disc to get all the way cherry, and you don't really reach full heat until that disc gets all the way up to temperature, which after looking at the manual or maybe one of the stickers on the back, I think it's like 1050 degrees is a maximum outlet temperature, so that's pretty stout. It definitely throws some heat when it's almost 1100 degrees, I'm sure.
So obviously I'm not going to record for 10 or 15 minutes to see what the temperature does, but I will check back in here shortly and we will see how quick it heats up this 600 square foot space. Alright, so it's been just about 15 minutes. Feels pretty toasty in here. Let's see where we're at. We are at about 64 degrees, so 15 minutes, picked up about 22 degrees in here. I don't know if you can really tell, but these thermostat and the heater are about as far apart. They're just about catty corner. There's the extreme corner right there. And it's actually behind this saw blade and a couple of tape guns there, so it definitely does not even have line of sight to the heater. There's what it looks like. You turn around and there you're square with the heater pretty much, so it's pretty shielded from it. I think that it has dramatically warmed up in here. I'm out here in a sweatshirt, a t-shirt, sweatshirt, pair of jeans, just a baseball cap, and at this point, honestly, I would probably switch it off. It's plenty toasty if you're going to be out here actually doing something. I need to get an insulation kit on this door, but it is plenty of blown-in insulation up above. It's nice attic steps here. I've been up there a bunch. Super happy with it. So if you've got a torpedo heater and you want to kind of go to the next level, get something that is a lot quieter. At this point, I definitely wouldn't hesitate to try one of these out. Obviously, it's a new style, it's a new form factor. It is Chinese made. What isn't, especially at this price point? But for $250, I don't think you can go wrong. I mean, not really going to know until after a couple of 100% reliable seasons with it what you're really going to get long term. Like I said in the first part of the video, I think this thing, honestly, I think it went 8 years with nothing. I don't even think it ever failed to ignite, even coming out of storage. There'd always be a little old kerosene left, put some fresh in it, and she would light right up. That's a pretty tried and true design, but it's noisy. It's definitely noisy and it uses a lot of fuel. This makes more heat and it is extremely quiet. I probably honestly should hook up the torpedo and kind of talk in the same level of volume, and you probably wouldn't really be able to hardly hear me. You just probably get a roar. I know that I actually watched the video earlier, and this thing sounds a lot louder playing it back than it really is. If you're standing here talking to somebody, you're not yelling at them like you are with the torpedo. There's definitely a small amount less odor as well, as far as kerosene smell when I go back inside to get a refreshing beverage. When you open the door and come back out, there is, I believe there is a little bit less of a fuel smell. But speaking of refreshing beverages, I think this pretty much covers it for this heater. Hope you enjoyed the review. And I'd say you're probably safe with either the Pro Temp or the Master Heater. I've got manuals downloaded for both of them, and they're the same unit. They're both made in China, and they're both sold by that Pinnacle Group. I don't know why they have decided to have two names, Pro Temp and Master Heater. But, all right, guys, thank you. See you.